Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki, I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is all about holes and how to make them bigger. So I'm going to let you process that while I take a sip of my matcha latte. So yeah. Kitty, and this one is for you. I know you've been dying for me to do this video, so here it is. You saw by the title, I'm assuming that, well, what this video is about. But basically, I'm going to tell you how I stretched my ears from just a normal piercing size to, well, this, which is now 8 millimeters. So yeah, before we begin, let's do kind of a round of disclaimers. I am by no means a professional piercer. I am not responsible for stuff happening to your ears. I'm only responsible for stuff happening to mine. And yeah, please go to a professional piercer for any piercing that you want, for advice, or just go to a piercer to have your ears stretched. I am a person that when I see something done, I can usually do it myself. Well, these types of things. For example, I shave my own hair, I bleach my own hair, I have been cutting my own hair and coloring my own hair for years. I also cut family members' hair. You know, I'm not a hairdresser, but I have watched quite a lot of hairdressers actually, and I can do the basics, you know? Same with fake nails. I had fake nails done years ago once, and I thought I can do that as well, and it will save me a lot of money. If I think I can do that, then I usually can. That's basically how I roll. Yes. It could very well be another disclaimer that it is kind of dangerous to drink in this video. I don't know. It could very well be that I say weird stuff, which isn't too weird for me actually, but just a disclaimer as well. So drink at your own risk, you know? So yeah, this is not a tutorial. This is just how I stretched my ears. I know some of you are wondering, Kitty, and are just really curious on how I did it. Now, it really worked out well for me, but that is also because I listened to my body, or my ears in this case. If I went a little too fast, which did happen, I kind of dialed it back a little bit. Does that make any sense? So just, you know, please don't take my word as law or pray, whatever. Go to a professional and ask, you know? So yeah, disclaimers out of the way, I think. And just use your freaking common sense, you know? I know it's quite rare, it seems to be, but use it because you got it for a reason. Okay, what did I use to stretch? I used this, the Borch Seed Oil from The Ordinary. I freaking love this stuff. I have raved about this on numerous occasions. I have currently 3 bottles floating around in my house because we put it on everything. Wounds, just on my face, on newly put on tattoos, and, well, stretching the ears. Why? Because it's anti-inflammatory and it's an oil. It sinks into your skin, but it has kind of a slip, and that slip is what you need. Yeah, you can also use, what's it called again? Petroleum jelly, but the other kind. Vaseline, that's what the word I was looking for. You can also use Vaseline, but it needs to have a slip. You could also use olive oil or sunflower oil. Your cooking oil. You can use that as well. I just prefer the Borch Seed Oil because it has those anti-inflammatory properties in it, and you are creating wounds while you are stretching your holes with oil or another lubricant. So yeah, you know, just go. Do not drink while I say the next piece, please. Yes, go slow. Use a lubricant, and if it hurts, stop. It's good advice regardless, but especially if you're going to stretch your ears.
Okay.
Now, so I use the oil. Yeah, I said so. Now, obviously you need, well, pierced ears. But before you go and start stretching your own, well, holes, basically, go to a piercer shop and ask if you can. And why do I say that? Because when I wanted to stretch my ears, I just went on AliExpress. First, I Googled how I needed to do that. And then I went on AliExpress and got sets of these. So I have, this is the biggest one in the set. They start at, well, basically, they are downstairs, of course they are. But basically this width, that's the starting point. So from basically 1 millimeter, and then you see that it tapers, you know, so here then it is 1 millimeter, and then it kind of tapers out to, I think it was 2 millimeters or something like that, the smallest one. So I ordered a set of these, and my tunnels came in from AliExpress, but not my stretching thingies. So I went to the piercer shop that we have here close by, and I asked if he had stretchers that I could buy, you know? And he looked at my the holes that I had in my ears, and he just basically said, you cannot do that. Because if you go and stretch them, they are, especially this side is too low, it will tear open, and then you will have, well, no hole, but just a tear in your ear. I think you can still see it here. That there, that is my hole, the oldest one. And this one is lower than this one, so they were uneven as well. It always irritated the hell out of me, but what can you do, you know? So he said we need to re-pierce, because if you go and stretch that, it just won't work. And the ones that I had above that were kind of too high up, you know, so when I would stretch it, they would be here, so that was not good either. So I needed to get re-pierced. I did, just, you know, between the holes and all that goodness. So I got re-pierced. Then the piercing shop that I went to get re-pierced gave me a little sachet, whatever, plastic baggie with Himalaya salt in it. And basically he is a fan of kind of more of the natural method. So he advised for me to buy a specific kind of soap. I will put a picture up here. I don't know if you can get the brand, but it's basically a soap without soap. Does that make any sense? And then I needed to wash the piercing twice a day for the first 3 days with that soap. And then, you know, just clean it out really well, rinse it out really well, and then pat dry with a paper towel. And then every 2 days I kind of needed to put a saline solution on it, because that is why I got the salt, so I could make my own saline solution and then just, you know, dab it on. I later found out that the wound clothy thingies, wound cleaners that I have at home are drenched in saline solution. So that made it a lot easier, because I still use those, because I'm still, they are still not completely healed yet. I still use those things to clean my piercings and the holes that I have in my ears. So yeah, so he advised that, and he gave me piercings, and they are, I think, 1.2 millimeters. I have one here. So you have a ball on one side, you have a flat side here, and then a ball, and it's basically 1.2 millimeters. That is it. So I needed to let those heal for about a month and a half, he said. I thought that was quite a long time. I get it, but I thought it was pretty long time, and I did not want to kind of wait that long, but fine. So I really asked him. I said, okay, how do I know that they are healed enough to stretch? And he just said, when they stop hurting. So when you can really touch them, you know, and can squeeze and it does not hurt anymore, no fluid comes out, you know, that kind of thing, then it is basically okay to go and stretch. But he said, I would rather that you wait a little bit longer. That was his advice. So okay. I'm not the one to kind of try mess up and then go crying to him in this case, because I was like, I have common sense. I know it's debatable for some, but I do have it. And I was like, you know, I'm going to see. I read online that some stretch from the initial piercing to this, which is 8 millimeters in 2 days. I would not advise that. It took me, how long did it take me? I don't know. So let's say the beginning of May, thereabouts, I got the piercing. And we are in July, so say 2 months, that I went from the 1.2 to 8. And that is pretty quickly, to be honest with you. So how did I do that, you may ask? Well, first, you kind of need holes on the correct, you know, placement. And they need to be healed enough so that you can stretch. Then you need stretchers, obviously. I will leave everything that I ordered from AliExpress down below in my description box, just so you know. But there are two, well, there are more types of stretchers, but I have two types. I ordered these, the spirals. I have three sets. I have the green one, I have a pinky one, and I have a black one. And the weird thing is, though, with these are actually all the same size that I have here. They're the biggest. This one, though, is bigger than this one. I don't know if you can see that. This one is bigger here. I think this is 10. This one I can pull all the way through. This one I kind of stop there. Because if I go further, my ear says, "Woohoo, you're stretching again." So I think that the green one, it goes to, well, 9 or 10. So yeah, you kind of... The easiest ones to stretch are these, which are straight. These are the easiest to stretch with. Because you can, you know, yeah, they're just easier. Really? So, how did I start? Actually, the smallest one of the black was the smallest one in the whole set. The first one was a little bit too thick to stretch with immediately. I did not really want to kind of penetrate the hole. Yes, that's what she said. Fortunately for me, though, my son's girlfriend was also in the process of stretching her ears, and she had a straight set. So she gave me the smallest ones, which are these, which are very cute and tiny, and they go from, well, 1.2 to, I think, 1.5 maybe, or maybe even 2 millimeters. I think it's 1.5, it could be 2, I don't know. But yeah, so these were actually the first stretchers that I put in my ears, and then I could actually, well, push these through pretty quickly, and then I could kind of go to the spirals. The only downside is with the spirals that I have here, you see this black thing, that is a stopper. They did not come in this set, so that was kind of a bummer. So what I actually did was I got very, very tiny black rubber bands. We usually used those for horses back in the day, for their manes, you know, very tiny rubber bands, and I just used those as a stopper, you know. I just twisted it around and used it as a stopper, because yeah, why not? You know, every time I went to stretch, I just made sure that my ears were clean. Then I rubbed or massaged the board seat oil in my ears, and I also disinfected the piercing that I was going, or the stretcher I was going to use, and then I rubbed oil on it to just make sure that it would kind of glide through. Then I would push it through until it kind of went like that feeling, you know, and then I would stop, and then my ear would do woof, woof, woof. I would put a stopper or the rubber band thingy on it and wait it until that was done, and then I just kind of waited until it felt kind of good to stretch again. Well, not really good, but and also not really comfortable. So it's, the stretching process is kind of uncomfortable, but it shouldn't hurt like a mother effer. Does that make any sense? So when it hurts, you need to stop. I had these in while sleeping as well, and I just made sure that I put them in like this to sleep, so that when it pushed, it kind of pushed it out instead of further in. Does that make any sense? So I would not kind of stretch my ear while I was sleeping by accident. Well, not sleeping by accident, but then stretching by accident. And there were just days that I just could not sleep because this thing was poking me here, you know. So I went to my piercer and I said, "I need to sleep. Give me tunnels." And then it was at 3 millimeters, apparently. And I got these. These are my first tunnels. And I had these in for, I think, a week and a half, maybe, to really give my ears, time to settle down a bit. And I could, just take these out and clean them. And, you know, sometimes I found that if I cleaned my ears and then wanted to put it back in again, it did not really want to go all the way through because my ear was like, oh, I can go back down again. Then I would just take one of these and then, of course, always put oil on and then really kind of wiggle it back and forth so it was, the hole was big enough so I could put the tunnel in again. That's basically what I did. And then when I had the 3 millimeters in for a few, well, for about a week and a half to 2 weeks, I kind of felt like it was okay to stretch again, like I do now. My ear is still a little bit tender, but it does not really hurt, you know. And so I could stretch again if I wanted to now. I don't though, because I kind of like these, this size, at least for the moment. And this is 8 millimeters that I have now. So yeah, my goal was 6, because I have 6 millimeter tunnels here that I ordered from AliExpress, and they're very cute. So I have these, which have a webby thingy, and I have these, which have a holy thingy. So these were the ones that I ordered, and I actually ordered more, and more are still on the way, because I ordered the 6 before I decided I wanted to go to 8. So yeah, the only real mistake that I made was when I went from 6 to 8, because I was always really careful to stop when my ear said, I don't like you very much right now. Then I would just, you know, leave it at the size that I was then. I would clean it. And the nice thing that I found with these is that you can kind of, you can do that, you know, so you can really put oil on and then just go and make sure that the oil is also in your ear. So yeah, but the mistake that I actually made with going from 6 to 8, and let me take the, I have these in now, which are silicony. They are soft and they are fantastic. They are really easy to put in as well, because you scrunch them up a bit and then you just push it in and it does floop, and then you have this. The downside is, because these don't have any weight to them, your ear hole kind of does this. So yeah, but they are really, really comfortable. I just would advise not to use these when your ear is open, that it is a wound, that it is maybe fluid is coming out, or maybe it is bleeding a little bit. Don't use these. You can put them in, but if you then want to take them out, that hurts like a mother effer. And that was the mistake that I made. I went too quickly from 6 to 8, and it teared. So I bled quite a lot actually, and that was the only time I really bled, was when I went from 6 to 8. What did I do? Silly me. I used these because these were the biggest, and I thought I'm at 8. I kind of was at 8. Well, no, I wasn't really. I was at 7, if I'm being honest. And then I went and put this in. I really wiggled. I really struggled. I wiggled, and then finally it did plop like it is now. That hurt pretty badly, actually. But yeah, when I have one, I need the other one as well, you know? So that was, I did not sleep that night a lot, at least, because my ears were, they were really, really hurting. And that was not a good move on my part. So what I did is I wanted to take them out again. And that was even worse, because that, it has kind of a, that edge that is on here feels really, really sharp then. And I just tore open, well, the inside of my ear, basically. So yeah, I needed to let that heal again. And then I got these, which are like this, but then just straight. And I put these in, used a lot of oil, put these in and just let them heal basically. And then I put in my tunnels. These are 8. And I was at 8. So yeah, but let me kind of show you what it looks like when I stretch. So now I have taken it out and I have the holy here. So basically what I did was I took my oil on my fingertip and then did that. Then I took the piercing and I rubbed oil on it as well. And then you just put it in. And it goes to here quite comfortably. And then when I go a little bit further, I usually did this back and forth a bit. And then every time I kind of, you know, push down, I push down a little bit further. That is how I stretched. So, and now you have here the straight one. Same thing. Let me put in a little bit of oil. Only these go like that. These are easier though than the spirals. But yeah. And then you can use these to help get your tunnel in. So I have here my 8mm tunnel. I just put it on top of the piercing and just kind of, well, push it through was the idea, but I cannot do that while I'm talking to you. And now it does not want to go in. I need to be careful because my ears are still healing. That was the word I was looking for. So I just really gently kind of pushed or pulled my earlobe over my piercing. Does that make any sense? I hope so. You don't want to do that because yeah, that kind of hurts. So yeah, now I have this and I can then screw the back on. I hope. No, I have this one. So yeah, so these are quite easy. Same with this. These are quite easy to put in as well. And then I got, as a gift, I got these, which these are hearts, but these are a little bit more difficult to put in. I haven't been able to put these in yet, but that's also probably because my ear hasn't completely healed yet. And it is still, yeah, a little bit, I don't know, sore, dense, I don't know how to call it. But yeah, this is, I think, yeah, this is how I stretched my ears. So yeah, I hope it was helpful. I will leave all the links that I used down below. And please, please be sensible. And, you know, don't expect that if you have holes, just, you know, your normal piercing holes, that you can immediately start with this one, which is 8mm at the ending here. Yes, it will maybe fit until there, but just go slow, you know. I would rather that you, well, took about half a year, that I should also have done probably, than to go as fast as I did and then ruin your earlobes. Because you really can do that. If you have blowouts, if you have scar tissue that then forms, it can just, you know, it's not good. So yeah, just give your body time to heal in between stretching. So yeah, guys, if you have any questions, leave them down below. And please remember, I'm not a professional. This was not a tutorial. This was just how I did it. So yeah, again, be smart about it. It's okay if it... well, do not drink. Just saying. It's okay to feel uncomfortable. It's okay if it stings a little bit. It's not okay if it hurts. You need to stop. And yeah, use a lubricant. Make sure that what you use is clean. Don't use alcohol. Oh, I forgot to tell you that. Don't use alcohol to disinfect because alcohol really dries out. You can use alcohol to disinfect your tools, so your stretchers, but don't use alcohol to disinfect the hole itself, because that really dries it out and can even make it worse. So yeah, just, you know, use a saline solution and maybe a nice oil or something like that. I think that's it, guys. Yeah, please let me know if it was helpful. And maybe if you have done this yourself as well, leave your tips and tricks down below. Leave below what you used to stretch, because yeah, it can really help others, I think. So yeah, this was it. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below, but be nice about it. Otherwise, I'm going to stretch your ears. I don't know. I'm going to stretch your earlobes so that you can push them back over your ears again. Does not really matter, does it? Thank you so freaking much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you soon in my next one. Bye, guys.